Okay, after setting up the server, we will now install the client. First we have to do for the client, we have to install our SUSI. You can go to our webpage support.advantech.com.tw, insert the model of your client, for example like here UTC520, and you can download the latest SUSI. I have done it already, I put it here, or setup, and I will install SUSI right now. Just by double click, it will start the install shield wizard. Okay, we are going to next. We have to agree the license agreement. Next, we just keep the default installation path of SUSI. Next, and install. SUSI also will automatically install the .NET framework if it is not available on your system, so you don't have to care about this requirement anymore. If you have already installed the .NET framework, it's also not a problem. SUSI will not touch your installation if it is already done. It asks you if you want to restart now. No, we don't want to restart. But we want to check if SUSI is working, so we are going to start. All programs. Advantech. We should find a folder SUSI 3.0 and a SUSI demo inside. So we are just clicking on SUSI demo. The demo program is opening and we are going to the about page. We are checking if the model is correct. UTC520D, yes. BIOS version is recognized. Let's have a look on the hardware monitor. Click on monitor. Yes, the voltages are monitored, the temperatures are monitored, the fan speed is not monitored because we have no fan connected. Okay, that's it so far. SUSI is working. I want to check a last thing. I want to see if our SUSI DLL is also in the System32 folder. And I'm looking for SUSI DLL. It's here, perfect. So we can close this folder. And we are going to our installation for SUSIaccess client. The first section is talking about wake on LAN. If you want to restart your system automatically, that means if you want to send it to sleep mode and wake it up again, you have to enable wake on LAN on your platform. I'm not going to set it up. Set some kind of easy thing and working a little bit different on every platform, so I'm just skipping this part and going directly to the installation process. We want to install also our eSOS, which is our backup and recovery solution in case if your system will crash. For this, we have to reboot the system and boot into the bootable USB stick. Keep in mind, we make sure you have downloaded from our website. Just go to our website, download the image, put it bootable on a USB stick, and then we can use it. So we are going now to start and reboot. Now it's booting into the mini Linux, the eSOS. The first screen we see, it is asking us if we want to install eSOS and SUSIaccess client. We have a lot of other options, but we are choosing install right now. So it is checking the requirements and it is highlighting us right now that it has to repartition the hard disk. We say yes, please. Then we have to enter the IP address for our server. For the SUSIaccess server, the server port and the console port should be okay so far. So we are just changing the IP address and clicking on OK. It is asking us if we want to use FTP or HTTP for backup. We are choosing FTP in this case. If you have no FTP, you can also choose HTTP. Then it is asking us if we want to use VNCs. That's necessary if you want to do remote view of your desktop. So we use it, yes. Do you want to enable email alert? If you want to enable email alert, you need an email account which you can access from your machine. I don't have one, so I'm going to no. And then it is asking us if we want to backup the image to the FTP or HTTP right now. So we are choosing yes. And then it's starting to resize the disk partition, installing eSOS and a bootloader. It will copy SUSIAccess client files. Be a little bit patient. At 70%, it could be that it takes some time, so just keep patient, please. After the backup is done, it will restart Windows. The first time you will have a check disk, which means it has recognized that the system partition was changed. It will check the partition. Then it will start, install the SUSIAccess client, and restart automatically the system. So just do nothing and wait for this restart.